It's February 2014. This is Le Mont Saint-Odile. There's the monastery. I already filmed this once in summer. And this is the pagan wall. They call it Le Mur Païen. It's one of the biggest mysteries in Western Europe. Nobody knows who did it or really when. Must have been at least 4,000 years ago. And how they got these big rocks here. It's a very mystical area. Nobody here. It looks like prehistoric concrete to me with all those pebbles in there. So I'm gonna do some fasting here for a few days. I won't eat, won't drink a few days. It's a good area for it, there's nobody here. Here we can see what's left of the wall. At other parts it's still like intact. It's one of the best things to do, you know. I need my body and mind, you know, to have a rest after the hell of Switzerland. And so just put up your tent, you know, go to sleep, don't eat. So this is what I showed you before, you know. They had this special thing to attach the stones. Well, you don't see it that well here. But here it's lifted here. This is not that clear, I have to show it somewhere else. Maybe here. No. Well, I'll find it. Tomorrow I'm gonna walk the whole way down. I came here together with a German guy, but we lost each other on the way up in a little village of Bar. I suppose it was meant to be then. So I hitchhiked and I walked the whole way up. You know, the aim of fasting is to give your belly, your stomach, a rest. So not to put anything in it. The only way to do it, really do fasting or long-term or medium-term fasting, is like sitting in the sun in India and don't do anything. Or here it's too cold, it's winter. Now you can see some snow here, what's left here. So here in Europe, the only way in winter to do it is lie in your tent and do as little as possible. Yeah. So I'll fast for like 48 hours and then on an empty stomach I'll walk down and I'll hitchhike. Yeah. So it's not very long, 2 days, but the thing is, it gets boring, you know. We're so used with a lot of input, television, computer, talk with people, go party here, party there. Therefore, a lot of people, this would be boring, you know, so they can't. And, yeah. So give the old stomach a rest and lie down the body and just let nature do its work. You know, the healing work. So I just go to sleep, get my body a rest. And I just think, well, damn. Fuck it all, I'm not there. This is actually something people used to do before, you know, when there was not so much distraction going on, you know. The Jews did it, and some of them still do it, like on the Sabbath. The Muslims do it like 1 month a year, and the Native Americans do it for 96 hours. And yeah, I used to do that a lot more. Just give it all a rest. But as I'm not religious, I don't belong to any of those. I just do it my way. No, why not? It's funny, really, how things work out. I wanted to show this German all this because he's very religious, and there's this monastery here with the Saint Odilia. And so he probably never made it here, and I didn't even want to go here. I did it for him, and it's me ending up here and doing my fasting. And so sometimes, you know, you get pushed into a way you didn't even want to do, but if you look at it closely, in the end it was altogether a good thing. It's a synchronicity, you know. So I take it as it is. I just think, well, I had to come here and I do my fasting, and tomorrow I'm going to walk down on a very empty stomach after 2 days of fasting, complete fasting, no drinking, nothing. And well, it was meant to be. Funny thing is, this guy probably never made it here. Weird way sometimes, eh? When I put up my tent while it was dark, I forgot to look up. There's some real rotten branches over me. Oh dear. That's no good. No, I'm too lazy to get it all off, to get my tent away now. And this one here is right over my tent. I hope it's not going to snap there. I hope it's not going to be windy. Oh, look at that part. That's no good. That doesn't look very good. So this is pointing down on my head here. And I'm right over my tent here. Well, good luck. That reminds me of that film, The Omen. A dead branch over my head. So there you can see the pagan wall. So I fasted for 44 hours until now. Didn't eat, didn't drink. And here too, this is the pagan wall. Here it goes on. Here. It's at least 4,000 years old. Well, no, 4,000 before Christ, 6,000 years old. And as I showed you before, they have this special way to connect the stones as we can find in Egypt. Well, I don't see it here now. They call it the pagan wall. Really big blocks of stone. Who did it? How? Why? To keep somebody out? To keep them in? Here too, the pagan wall. And it's going to rain again. And there it is again, the pagan wall. Over 20 kilometers long. It's going all the way here. A bad day for filming. And we can see in some places the wall is quite high. This is quite high here, all over.
So you can see it's quite high. I took my umbrella out now, so I can make some videos here. This is not easy videotaping with an umbrella. You know, I have to keep both. I'm doing it with one hand now. That's not easy. So this is still the pagan wall, this. I slept here on a sporting ground. There's the motorway. And there's my petrol station. Yeah. Total. So I have to get out here first. I didn't eat enough for almost 3 days. More than 60 hours. I only drank yesterday, I drank some water. So the best thing to do, it's like if it's the weekend and you can't get any food, or it's like a holiday, like Christmas, and everything is closed, you know, just stay low and try to sleep, or be in your sleeping bag and in your tent. And yesterday I did a lot of hiking, actually, on an empty stomach. I walked down the Le Mans Centre d'Ile. I hitchhiked all the way to Strasbourg, where I am now. It's a big town. So I'm going to hitchhike further down, further up, actually. So today's Thursday. The last time I ate was on Monday, so see if we can get a bite somewhere. See if we can find some garbage cans. You know, in France, I know this by experience, there's always a gate somewhere, somebody opened it, you know, like here. People who want to, you know, kids who want to come and play soccer. They always break it open somewhere and see that it fits back again, you know. I mean, if I close it back here, it won't even show. So I close it back, yeah, I guess. Well, it hardly shows, you know. And so this is how I got in. Otherwise it's a bit hard, you know, get over the top here. You know, the French people, they don't like gates and prisons, you know, they open them up. You wouldn't see this in Switzerland. No way. So this is how you get in a fairly big town, a safe place to sleep. Because there won't be coming anybody in here in the night. There's only some kids who want to play soccer, you know. Maybe they're just loosening up the screws here. Quite a decent way to do it. So otherwise, you know, wouldn't like to be sleeping there in the outskirts like here, you know, of a big town. No way. So these are just the things to do. By the way, this part of town of Strasbourg is called Ostwald, like Lee Harvey. Or maybe Lee Harvey was Swiss as well, who knows. So, well, apparently here they celebrate Christmas all year round, eh? Every night they say, Happy Christmas, have a party. Why not? I heard about people doing that. They're having Christmas every night. Having a big party every night, you know, after work or don't work or whatever. Look, that guy is tired of the party. So now we're February 2014. Happy Christmas! It says Oswald. Hi, Lee Harvey. Terrain Omnisport. Well, that's probably why I slept last night. No more Lee Harvey. Or maybe it was without a tea, I don't even remember. Most people think of France like the wine, you know, they think of the wine, the cheese, lying on the beach, lying on your back the whole day. But actually these people are quite industrious. They even have their own car brands. They got three car brands. This is the Lion car, it's called Peugeot. And they have this brand here, it's called Renault. And they have a car called Citroën with the Apes logo of the Pharaohs. And the interesting thing is here that the Italians are well known for their racing cars and fast cars, the Germans for muscle cars, big German fast cars. The French, they don't have that. They seem to be just satisfied with a car that brings them from A to B in a comfortable way. Well, like this, like a car like this here. Oh, looks like, and they got very, very good seats in it, very comfortable. That's probably the only thing they care about. Well, why not? Then it raises the question, and what are they interested? We used to have one like that. In front of a big caravan. Oh, that's Peugeot as well. Yeah, in what are they interested? For most men, their car is the most important thing, you know. I know it sounds stupid, but it is, really. And it doesn't seem to be the case in France. Interesting. And I guess the English, they like to fix their old cars. You know, being sort of nostalgic from a time when British cars were still being made. All the European peoples are sort of different. Interesting, though. So this symbol here of the French, the petrol station here, it's also the three rings here, like the Vatican Pisces, which is Isis, Horus and Seth. If it's the number three, it's always the same thing. It's always Isis, Horus and Seth.
Great.
Salut. And so it's like the Vatican Pisces, the rings keeping together, like, just the cops passing by here. So at the same time, these three Vesica Paiches rings, they form the world. And it also says total, as in total control of the world. It's all there in the symbols. It's everywhere. As you can hear, there's an enormous storm coming up. I already planted my tent here, you can see. Like this tree is bending over that side, you know. And this tree is quite alright, there are no branches over my head. I already thought about it. But then these guys over there they are, they woke me up in the morning and said, well, the ground is not hard enough and they can, you know, tip over just like this here. And when I was hitchhiking, everybody has been telling me that there's an enormous storm coming up. And I thought that was in the night and it was already over, like, in the night. But apparently it'll be coming in a few hours. So I'll let you see it. And well, the birds were making some funny noises, like whistling and, quite funny noises in the morning, actually. They're like announcing it.
Non, mais on voit
bien. Mais je pense que j'ai même pas filmé, je sais pas. So these guys, they woke me up here. I don't know if I was filming. So this is where I slept.
one next to it, reptilians, and there's some other funny creatures there. Fleur de lis all over. And here the sun hieroglyph. I can't film very long because so here they used to put people inside before it's a prison, you know, in the tower. It's always a tower. Look, it's like they still got the bars here, the prison bars. Nice, eh? Everybody could see you who came here, like. So you can hear those guys sawing where I slept. Says the résidence du château, that's the house of the castle, like. And here are the Templar symbol, three stripes here, or maybe you could say it's two. And the Templar's cross here. Right, winter's coming up, right? Ah, here too, you know. Wahoo would put these grills in their garden big like this. You think it's without the significance? Ha! No way. That means we are pharaonic descent. We live here. While seeing the look at the windows. They even put the triangle board in front of the windows. Look at it. Three times. What do you know? Well, that's quite obvious, isn't it? That means our blood is here, we are here. These are obviously, looking at the size of the mansion here, they are quite small pharaohs. It's a nest here, quite big. That's interesting, they got the police inside of I don't know what it is, a castle or something. Well, they always were, in fact. In the castle, before the castle, before. So this is the silence for the storm. It's supposed to be coming up any moment in the next few hours. In a little town I'm going. If it's all closed like you can see here, you know, it's usually a Freemasonry lodge. It doesn't have to be, but I can see here Isis in the middle of the sun hieroglyph, so it is a bit funny, all these things here. Just before, some guys that took me hitchhiking, and they saw my films, and they were very in French, and they were very surprised. That was funny. You know, this symbol I see everywhere. It's Pas de Calais. It's the region here. And you see, there's a small green pyramid. I mean, that's us. We're visible. And then there's a bigger pyramid, and at the top it's all getting like invisible, like in a fog. It's sort of foggy, you don't know who's what, or, you know, it's sort of air, blue and air, they're in the air. So that's the top of the gang, you know, of the hierarchy. Well, that's what it means. So here I'm hitchhiking on this long, lonely road here. There's nobody who wants to take me, really, nobody who's willing to do so. They all say, well, somebody's stopping. Yeah, nice, good. Hey, nice, in a Renault. This is Edin in France. There's a little mansion just like in between. What we got here? Fleur de lis. So who is living here then, eh? So this is in Edin. Looks a bit suspicious, but can't really find a lot of things on it. It is a very suspicious building here. Yeah? Well, here's the Fleur de Lis all over, of course. I suppose there's a lot more things to see. There's another Fleur de Lis. So this is in Edin. Market Square. So this is a strange building here. Just with all these ornaments.
middle of nowhere here, or don't see any similar things. And it says the Institute for Young Girls. Oh, that sounds really like the first rite of the pharaohs and the Freemasons. So here they keep some young girls. Oh. Well, no, it's lion. Symbol of the aristocracy and the pharaohs. Well, this is the church here in Ida, still in Ida. Looks more like a voodoo church. Well, aren't they all? They're all like voodoo churches, aren't they? Oh, there's even an Indian there. Where is he? Where do you go? Oh. Indian chief. Or is it a pharaoh? Well, there's probably a lot of things to see, but see it later. So this is still in Ida. There's the other weird building. So?
No, we're going to take off.
Okay.
J'ai fait pas mal de trucs comme ça.
Ok.
Et ça, c'est typiquement bourguignon, hein?
Ah, bourguignon?
Ah, bah oui, hein.
Ok.
Ah oui, c'est bourguignon, puisque celui qui a fait l'église, c'est quand même le fils de Charles Quint.
Ok.
Oui, mais comment qu'il était? Il était duc de Bourgogne.
Oui.
Voilà. Alors il me dit, papa, il dit, on m'a demandé de faire partie des francs-maçons.
Oh là 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 là.
Aïe aïe, il me demande ça à moi. J'ai dit, je peux pas t'empêcher de ne pas le faire.
C'était juste là maintenant, récent?
Hein?
Récent?
Oh, il y a une dizaine d'années. Parce qu'il a 40 ans maintenant, oui, ouais. Oui, il y a une dizaine d'années.
Et qu'est-ce qu'il a fait?
Ah, moi, il m'a demandé mon avis, moi, j'ai donné un mauvais avis. J'ai dit, ne rentre pas là-dedans parce que au début, t'es jeune, on va se servir de toi.
Ah oui.
Et c'est pas possible. Enfin, tu fais ce que tu veux, mais je ne l'ai pas
retenu.
Non, je ne l'ai pas vu.
Mais le truc, ça, avec le, quand tu rentres là-dedans.
À Arras, c'est 80% de tous les dirigeants, ils sont francs-maçons.
Ah oui.
Ah oui, hein? Ah oui, c'est Arras, c'est...
Toutes les politiciens, tout.
Les gens qui ont fait la révolution, Robespierre et tout le bazar, toutes ces équipes-là, c'est tout franc-maçon.
Oui, exactement. So, this is my Fluor toothpaste. And there's a lot of people that say now with all the conspiracies, there are conspiracy, I mean, that's a real thing. But in some cases, you shouldn't exaggerate it. Fluor is not good in the water. But I mean, I'm getting 52, I've still got my teeth. I think thanks to fluor, fluor is a big poison apparently. And that's what you need, that's what you want, to kill all the bacteria in your mouth. You know, before people died, you know, at the age of 24 because of a tooth infection, you know. Now we can live, you know, with our teeth until we are 60 or I don't know, 65 and still have our teeth. So I think it's great, you know. That's what I want. I want something that's poisonous, like this, fluor, to kill the bacteria, you know, so I don't have a tooth infection. So, don't exaggerate with the don't believe everything. No. Of course, fluor is a poison. This is what I want. And, that's all I wanted to say. There's the V1. The V1 launcher. And here, I'm going to sleep. Good night. Actually, I keep the fluor and the toothpaste long in my mouth So I mix it with water, and then I rinse it, you know, I keep it in my mouth so it gets in all holes, you know. So I guess it's a good thing. Fluor is not that bad as, you know, the conspiracies say. But it's not good in the drinking water. It's not. It needs to go to your teeth and not in your stomach. So if I rinse it, you know, afterwards and spit it out, you know, well, most of it is out. And the bacteria's out. That's what I want.
I'm here in Boulogne-sur-Mer. It got quite windy again, stormy last night, so I put my tent next to this, next to the Hague here. And it's another sporting ground. This part is open. It's not like in Switzerland. Even this here, the tennis court is open. It's only to, you know, to catch the balls. So I was afraid somebody might walk into my tent maybe in the night. So I hung up this the rope here and another one there. So if somebody would pass, he would feel, you know, something there. So I'll take that away now. Good. Another day in paradise. Even in the old days, I've always been using this here. Our grain is here. And look how it's all closed here. Freemasons. Hermerang. Hermites. Lots of place to park. Outside of town, quiet. It's always in ancient, like, aristocratic things, like, you know. There's a Freemason lodge here. Where they do their dirty things here. With kiddies. There's not a little castle here like this. Let's see what the coat of arms says. I'll probably look at it later. There's the coat of arms. There we go. Ah, Templar's cross. And it says Napoleon was here 4 years during the Battle of Boulogne. Oh, 2 years, sorry. And he is royal. Of course he is. Another part of the castle here. A little castle. That's an interesting building too. Ah, these are some real badasses here. Welcome at the pharaohs. Welcome in the pyramid. And this one here. Three sixes. You know, like this symbol. Like this symbol here. Like what all the music stars are doing, you know. Oh, there it is. If you're pharaonic as well, we give you a good price. There's even the half the crescent moon in it. Wow. Boulogne-sur-Mer. Bloody pharaohs. Now what are all the cameras for? Next to this damn thing here. Ah, the obelisk. I see it. I see. There's some more obelisks. The symbol of the pharaonic domination. This is a pharaonic nest here in Boulogne-sur-Mer. That's why there's a tower. Well, this thing here is full of obelisks. Now look at this here. Templar's cross. The joining.
Why is this? That's on your hieroglyph. There it is. Ah, this is pharaonic stuff. Some dragons there. That's why it's full of cameras.
So in times of hunger, the French people, they started eating everything. So this is a rotten cheese, actually. It's full of mycoses all over, you see that? And they eat it, it's called Roquefort. It's entirely rotten. They eat snails, you know, in times of hunger, they started to eat everything, just like the Chinese do. Well, I've been having a pain in my kidneys for the last 2 weeks. This is my cider. So, this cheese has natural antibiotics. So, I'll have a look if it works. I think it will.
So, this is the French rotten cheese. Just nicked it in the supermarket. Yeah, it's not that easy anymore.
But I can survive here, you know, for years. I've got my equipment, and if I would stand in front of a supermarket like that one there, Carrefour, and I would ask the people, excuse me, can you buy me something to eat? The first one would buy me something to eat, you know. So I'd survive for years, and I did actually. Yesterday the Swiss, they vote for another law against the immigrants, against people like me. So this time the international community will take a stand and, you know, get rid of them. There's an American in France who's going to take me to Bologna. Here inside a thing, it's called Nausicaa. Ka. It means the soul in pharaonic, the living soul. It's sort of a living museum where you can see animals. Well, this is the all-seeing eye. It's a fish in it, but it's definitely the all-seeing eye, and it's the vesica pycis, the two circles forming the oval in between. They got it all over, you know. Oh, it's nicely done. It's like all blue in here. Love kitties. Love boxes being shipwrecked. Marseille. Yokohama. Yeah. So they do have that logo. It's always the same, the ones who are in ship control, the ones who are in charge, is all Freemasonry and pharaohs. And that's me.
There's the all-seeing eye fish. But it's nicely done, actually. There's the sea, it's quite rough. Whole places like underwater in Brittany. That's in France. Brittany is where the Celtic people live, or France. Nausicaa, it sounds like vesica, and there's the pycis, which means fish. Vesica pycis, it's all there. It's very nicely done. Poor animals though inside. But it's, they got their fingers in it all over, you know? It's Freemasons and pharaohs. So, interesting. I just got the book of Gerald Williams about Hitler in Argentina. And here in Boulogne-sur-Mer, I just passed the museum of the general San Martin. José Francisco de San Martin, the guy who liberated Argentina from the Spanish. So he lived here in France. Very interesting. So this was his house. All these guys have their hands in their pockets. Bunch of Freemasons. Another one. Freemason floor. Another one with his hand in his pocket there. Where's his hand? There. The hidden hand. Some pictures from Argentina. Liberating the country. Oh, we can see the Freemason shake. There you go. Some old costumes, Argentina. Another shake. Don José de San Martin. In fact, the name Don, it's Hebrew, it's Jewish, it means Adonai, Adonai. It means a Lord. Templar's cross here. There you go. It's all Freemason bunch. Well, there's a whole wall with I don't know what. I suppose that's the Battle of Argentina. Here's a whole lot of generals and stuff. Argentina uniforms. There's another one. And in his pocket, another pickpocket. Templar's cross. I call them the pickpockets. Well, that's what they do, robbing the peoples, you know. But it's interesting. How the hell did I get here, you know? Ah, that's the poor Argentinian peasant. Ah, well, I know what that is, eh? Huh. Okay. Another pickpocket there. I suppose that's him. And, I suppose here they've got their victorious Battle of the Falklands. Well, not really that victorious, but well, they show it as something victorious. Yeah, some more generals and stuff. And of course, they got this sort of a pharaonic flag here, you know. Well, let's have a look at the top floor. Well, another pickpocket. All pickpockets. It's probably the aristocracy all over, you know. Well, there he is again, the savior of Argentina. He doesn't have a pocket, so he just holds his hand on his breast or whatever. So this is probably where he died. This is where he did his writing. Asking help from the French Freemasons.
Another shake here. It's full of shakes, ain't it? The octagon clock is ticking. I hope the octagon clock is ticking away for them. But I'm quite tired of the bunch. I don't know, here's another room here. Oh, this is in fact the Falkland. So here are a lot of pilots who gave their lives for the, in 1982 for Argentina. They're sinking some British battleships there. I'll already show that. Another roundabout. They always put things on roundabouts. So if there's three, that's Isis, Horus and Seth. There's the sea. Right. That's where they came from. So one of them is the biggest, one of them the smallest. I suppose Horus, the smallest, the sun. Then Isis in the middle, and Seth. A small imprisoned obelisk. This is funny. They're afraid somebody steals it or what, you know? This is the town I slept here. I asked some people, you know, of a camping spot if they would, in this little town between Boulogne and Calais, on a camping place. Well, it's a winter time, so it's closed. And they say, well, okay, well, it's not allowed because the police checks it all out. And then in the evening, he came with his son and brought me some soup. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? That's what I like about France. Quite solidary people. There's a little village here next to Calais with a Templar's cross in it. Nice. Two lions with a fleur de lis. So guess who's living there, you know? It's always the same. Guess who's living there? Descendants of the fair aristocracy. Probably some small ones. So just over there, all these people are sleeping outside, even some Polish. Here's a whole building, it's empty. You know, it's all empty. You can house them all in here, have it a bit cleaner. You know, so they can go to the toilet. But well, I mean, these are all house speculators, you know, the Freemasons. They rather have it all empty, these pharaohs. So instead of putting some people in there, it's all empty, see? Just around the corner. So there's the sun hieroglyph in a modern way. The empty building, all those people sleeping out there. Oh, nice society. There's a very long line in front of the tunnel, you know, to go to England. This is probably 3 miles or 2 miles, something like that. Probably because of the immigrants. They have to go check out every truck, like, you know. Oh, I had to put on my storm. This is real wet here. Look at it. Everything's wet. So I had to put up my storm lines here. Raining all the time. Got very windy. There's the, I was here before, there's the tunnel there, but it's going all the way around. They have to drive, you know, you can see another truck there, it's going all the way around, it's all blocked. So I'm
a real wetback now. And everything is blocked because of wetbacks like me. Yeah, look at it. Well, I'm a real wetback. Look at that. Everything is wet. Cold. The water almost got in my tent. Well, it did. So you can see part of the traffic jam going into the tunnel because of the wetbacks like me. All trying to get into a car, you know. That's going on here. They'll try to get into a car. And then let's go to England. It's all the way here. One truck after another. It's probably about 2 miles altogether. After they had the party yesterday with the music, they probably got bold and, you know, like, let's go to England, you know. And there's the tunnel for the cars, been here before. Pharaohs living here in Kazakh. The home of the red bonnets. We've been having rain and wind for almost 2 weeks now. Look at it.
J'ai pas la réponse du pourquoi.
Ah ben, mais j'ai pas eu directement. On va prendre ça comme du mépris du coup, hein, parce que si en plus il y a même pas une arme d'excuse, ça veut dire qu'ils se déplacent pas pour les chômeurs.
Voilà, c'est une quantité négligeable.
Ah bah oui, on a l'habitude d'être méprisé quand même. Oui, je pense que dire.
J'avais une petite question par rapport de...
Vous me filmez, je rêve.
Oui, oui.
Mais vous n'avez pas le droit de me filmer sans mon autorisation.
En fait, on n'a pas trop...
Non, non.
Ah. Est-ce que vous avez peur de quelque chose?
Moi, j'ai peur de rien.
Ouais. Alors, j'éteins?
Non, vous pouvez laisser allumer, ça ne me dérange pas.
Ok, c'est gentil. Pardon?
Il faut qu'on en discute collectivement de ça.
Là, on n'en a pas parlé, en fait, du coup, a priori.
Mais c'est juste une petite question. Je voulais demander, qu'est-ce que le gouvernement va faire contre l'évasion fiscale? Parce que tous ces problèmes...
Excusez-moi,
en fait, là, c'est une... Non, par contre, tu ne me filmes pas. On est dans une action collective, là. Du coup, ce serait bien d'arrêter, en fait, et qu'on en discute d'abord ensemble. OK?
So here in Kazakh, this is the... the unemployment office. There's some people there, and they occupied it inside here. And here you can see the police cars here. Where is he? There's one police car. There's another one. So they're going to. There's one more there, behind you. So they're going to charge the thing and, you know, throw them out. It's so windy, you know, I can only, like, be here, standing in the doorway. Let's see what's happening. I'll wait another half an hour. It's starting now. The bouncer cops just went in there. I'm not going, so these ones are just standing here. They're going to throw the people out. See what happens. out without any resistance. Look at the cops here. This is the bouncer team here. It's so windy, I can't keep my camera still. What's this guy doing? Oh. So here in Carex, these people, they don't have any more money. They're thrown like on the street. So in the time, in the town of Keltic, there's the name of it, Keltic, where the red bonnets are. So that was all, the cops are going. These guys here, coming there, they were cops in civil, spies, you know, civil cops, look at them, civil cops, the more civil cops, look at them. I think I better go now, probably erase my camera, you know, erase the video. Even here, an old building like this must be like from the Middle Ages. You can see the sun hieroglyph. Well, there it is, and on the other side as well. This is a pharaonic. It looks like a pharaonic temple, you know. Fascinating building. A lot of dark, sinister buildings here. And if you think, you know, you can just go and sit in the church because it's windy and it's raining, well, they're bloody closed. When you need them, they're closed. Sitting in Auschwitz or something, you need God, you pray, but he's gone, he's not there. You know? Sucks. All their heads are missing. What does that mean?
To talk to the mayor here, Mr. Christian Troidec. He's like the they have le bonnet rouge, the red bonnets, who are having battles in the streets with the police and the authorities. And but he said, I don't have any time, trees are falling down, all that. And he probably saw the look of me, my face is all red because I had 2 weeks only wind and rain. So he said, no, I have no time, but I'll, here we don't let anybody sleep out in Brittany. This is Brittany here, where these are Celtic people. So he called up the hotel and they have me sleep here. There was nothing I could do. But I'm very, very pleased. I'm so knackered. And this night is very dangerous. It's the winter so tense. It's so intense. So I didn't even ask anything. Well, they gave me a hotel for the night. So nice. So me, the hobo, is in a hotel. Well, that's change. Isn't it? Yeah. Well, see you later.
Montre-moi le pentagramme. Le pentagramme, là. Non, ça va.
Yeah. Ah, qui est flic?
Ouais.
Vas-y.
I'm here with some guys from Brittany, some real Celts. Don't like cops very much.
Incredible dirty here. And the guys are still sleeping. How can they live? Oh dear. What's that? So these guys invited me to sleep here. I didn't dare to sleep in the bed, so I slept on the floor, you know. And yeah, look at it. How can they live like this? You know? Oh. And look at the hairs and incredibly dirty. Things are ready to fall off here. How can anybody live like this? Huh? Well, the bath hasn't seen any water in years, I think. You know? No, but it was nice. I could sleep here. And I didn't dare to sleep in that bed either. I don't know where the other one was. Yeah, oh, it's smelling. So the hotel was so incredibly clean. But, well, these guys have an alcohol problem. Winos. So, well, you know, this happens when you're traveling. Loaded my camera, that's good. So I'm off on the road again. Yeah. I had a good night anyway. The wind has died down, thank God. I hardly dare to piss on the toilet, you know. I'm
too much afraid something might crawl back, you know. Look at it. I hope nothing did crawl back. Well, I've got my stuff packed, ready to say hello to the other one. You know, these people are Celts, you know, they speak Gaelic, and well, there's a big drinking problem. Salut, Stéphane!
Salut!
Et Eric, il est où?
Il est parti, pardon.
Sur le moto?
Ouais.
Ivré comme il était? I won't be surprised to find the other guy, outside, lying out somewhere. Yeah. Le cadavre, yeah. I've never seen drinking guys that much. And these are beers out there, they're all like 8% or 9%, you know? One after the other. It's quite a nice apartment where he's living. You know, two floors. It's probably the social department paying it. It's a very social country. And well, the entire people here has a very big drinking problem. Well, they are Celts, you know, they speak Gaelic. The same kind of Gaelic almost as in Wales, same people, who were chased by the Romans from their lands in France. And that was Caesar who did that. That was the biggest genocide probably the world has ever seen. And the same with Native Americans, they have a big drinking problem because of the genocide. They destroyed the soul of the people, you know, they never got over it, like. And the Celts have the same problem. Oh look, there's a G. Oh yeah. It's the sun hieroglyph. And here's the Freemason G, it's all over. And they are definitely no real Celts, those ones, they're pharaohs. So they crushed the soul of the people. Biggest genocide, they cut off the hands of all the men, destroyed villages, killed the children, the women. That's what Caesar did. He emptied France, and France is big. Now France was even bigger in those days. You know, when there were only horses, most of the people didn't even have any horses. And they play lovely music here, you know, Celtic music. Real great, like in Ireland. Some real good musicians, sensitive people. So, yeah, same with American Indians, broke the soul of an entire people. General Custer from Switzerland, Caesar, like Tsar, as in the sarcophagus, meaning the king, another pharaoh. He made himself like a king, like an aristocrat. Well, he was a pharaonic, part of the pharaonic nobility, of course. There's no doubt about that. They massacred the whole people because they resisted. Like the Native Americans. Well, and if you resist, they crush your soul. They crush the soul of an entire people. They crush the soul of an entire ethnicity. That's what they do. That's what they love. And then they try to build you up again with their new world, all this shit, and obedience and all that. So you just saw. I felt a bit sorry, you know, filming him, so I stopped, you know. But, big problem. The guy was only 40, the last one you just saw here. The other one was quite young as well. The one with the upside down cross on his cheek. He's saying, I'm a Satanist and all this, but of course he's not. He's just a lost person, you know. He was very nice, he brought me there, he didn't do any harm, you know. No, just complete, entirely lost person. And this is his way to resist, you know, to put a pentagram on his hand and an upside down cross
on his face. This is his way to resist and say, well, I'm a Celt, I don't want your shit, you know. And your pharaonic religion, we have our religion. It was perfectly all right. Poor guy. I saw him falling down a couple of times, Eric. And these guys, they drink. I mean, most people, they drink for the taste, you know, and just to chill out, relax. But these guys, they drink until they are either saved or until they die or fall down. Well, the other one was saved. They're probably both living on Social Security. So they got saved in a way, but they can still buy the booze. And yeah, they crushed the soul of an entire people. That's what they did. Caesar and his pharaonic bastards. Well, wasn't Caesar married with Cleopatra, eh? Still the same blood. They only intermarry with each other, like the royal houses today. It's the per a, it's the royal bloodline. The big house of the royal bloodline of the pharaohs. I really feel sorry for these guys, I really do. They still carry the burden of things that happened 2,000 years ago. And as they had these red bonnets people, you know, going into the street, the Freemason government, they're very much afraid, you know, that these people will stand up, and they talk about it, you know. There's maybe no other way, other part in France where people invite you home, you know, or so easily. I was here 20 years ago, and they invited me home. They didn't ask anything. They fed me. They put you in a hotel. This is Celtic, so they are noble people. They got noble hearts. Even the guy with the upside down cross. I mean, the Pope is having it as well, you know, so the upside down cross. And the other one, the normal cross is actually a bad sign because it's a sign of the crucifixion, you know. Like nailing somebody on a cross. So maybe the upside down cross is slightly better because you'd fall off, you know, if you're nailed on it. So, yeah, okay. I could talk for hours, but yeah. Probably see the other one. He even went away on his motorbike. He was probably in the police station or sleeping his thing out somewhere. It's a Sunday now, eh? So I'll go and hitchhike. Vesi Kapaitis in the same in Kai. Well, I just slept. Well, of course, this is a bank with a pyramid like this. Pharaohs. There's another bank with the Vesica Pisces. Three times, creating the oval and in a pyramid. Another bank here. Oh, what can I see here? Oh, there's the upside down V of the Templars, and well, there's probably a lot more to see. So I'm inside a McDonald's, you know, that's a good thing to do, you know, if you're like inside here. There were some youngsters, you know, some kids standing outside, and I asked them, excuse me, I'm a homeless, can you buy me something to eat? I think there they are. Most of them said no, and then there was a Muslim, an Arab guy, he said, yeah, wait a minute. And then another girl gave me something so I could buy two hamburgers of 1 euro each and a French fry, a chips of 1 euro. So I'm good for today. So it was the wind when I was in the hotel was blowing 180 kilometers an hour. Was that 140 miles an hour? I might have died, you know. It's, you know, all trees cracked and all that. So I suppose the mayor saved my life, maybe. Look at that. Yeah, so I'm very thankful to the mayor of Carré, Monsieur Christian Troadec. What the hell are you looking at, you know?
He's looking at me. So here you can see them fight the police, you know. That was Sunday. And this guy here, the mayor of this town, he put me in a hotel. And he's like one of the leaders of the red bonnets, as you can see here, fighting the system. And it says it's a danger of the European democracy what's happening in Switzerland, you know, Nazism. Here they even talk about Switzerland, the La Suisse Switzerland, you know, this guy here. So I hope somebody's gonna do something soon. So I'm still sitting in here in the McDonald's here, you know. I just came here in this fairly big town. I don't remember anything anymore where I used to sleep here. And the moon is looking very grim tonight. So where am I gonna sleep? Walk outside town, but I don't remember the way. Well, anyway, I'll just walk in one direction. Being followed. So I'm here in the middle of Rennes. I just started. Joggers running here. Well, I'm after behind the fence, near short of a shooting range. So I didn't have a map, you know, so I just look at the bus card where it's sort of green in town, you know. So this is what I do. This is like a bus stop, you know. So they got all these nice maps here, you know, where is it green? Oh yeah, it's nice and green. So I just take the bus or I walk there. And so I find a nice place to sleep in a town. Is the way to do it, or have a map, but then you have to buy it or nick it. And nowadays they got these things all over, even big ones, you know, with an index on it. Yeah. Now that's my bus. Ah, look at this strange obelisk looking down at the whole town here. This is in Rennes, in France. A lot of these sort of half castle big buildings here. There's Isis, the whore of Babylon. So here in Rennes, some strange obelisks. And here there's a real large sun hieroglyph here. And here's some small ones on a sort of a church. There's another small one here, there. I suppose there's a church here. So in France, even the bus drivers talking their cell phones, nobody cares, you know. So we're in a bloody dark forest here in the middle of the night. I don't know if you can see anything. If I would have a fast car, you'd see something. And maybe like this. So I've never seen any reptilians, aliens, or anything weird, you know, in the forest. There is absolutely nothing. In all those years, I don't know, 30 years I've been sleeping rough or more, I've never seen anything. So don't be afraid. There is nothing.
The only thing there is are spirits. I've had that. And they try to come in your mind. That's all. And mostly where there are buildings where bad things have happened, like human sacrifices and things like that. And the moment you want to go to sleep, it's like, chuck, you know, something tries to get in. Then you just have to go. I don't know what it is. It happened to me like 3 or 4 times. Well, the last time is 20 years ago, maybe. But in the forest, nah. Never. Don't be afraid of the dark. There's nothing. Never seen any reptilians, never heard anything. There's nothing. So, I like it, you know. Be with Mother Nature, that's awesome. Right. Moon in my forest. You can hear the motorway. Continue hitchhiking tomorrow. It's midnight. Brrr, midnight, full moon. What the fuck, you know? Well, good night. You know, big towns like are miserable. You know, but sleeping rough, you know, like so near to Mother Earth and in nature that heals the wounds. Get back your energy, you know. There's no energy in towns, you know. Well, not for a man. You know. So, it's one of the best things to do. Physically and then spiritually, it heals the, having a double tongue, yeah? It heals the wounds. Sleeping next to Mother Earth. In nature. That's awesome. Now this is how it looked like in the morning. You can hear my motorway. That was the moon. Good. So if you want to make a pillow in your tent, the best way to do is, you know, bundle your clothes and make a knot in your sleeves, like this here. Make a knot in it and then put it all together.
Bonjour, Madame Isis. So here in Alsace, in Bernhaupt, there's Isis. There is the Grail. And there's a sun hieroglyph. There's another one. And there on top is another one. The pharaohs living here. Now on top of the windows is the Freemasonry triangle. So here in Bernhaupt. So the pharaohs living there. Yeah, some more pharaohs on the other side of the road, probably kinfolk. It's a sun hieroglyph. And there again, the sun hieroglyph. So this was the same as this, there was the other house there with Mrs. Isis. And the Alsatians, well, they're from Switzerland. Well, what do you know? They originally came from Switzerland.